Okay, everyone, smoker.
Yeah, I'd fill up where I can if I were you. I wouldn't trust the regular, Tucker.
What, you mean with Lizzie on kitchen duty?
Lord knows what she's going to do to the food.
Oh, she's not such a bad cook, you know. She cooked me a real lovely meal once when we were living in the halfway house together. She made a wine trifle practically curl your hair.
Well, I see I'm not interrupting your work. Good. I have an announcement to make. Due to your abuse of the factory work project, it has been cancelled.
What do you mean, Mrs. Davidson? Our abuse?
Your agreement to work on non-government contract goods. How could you think you could be so stupid to get away with it? That is all. Carry on.
Well, that's funny.
Funny? Got a weird sense of humour, Doreen.
No, I mean, if she knew about the other work, how come nobody's getting punished for it?
Isn't not being allowed to work at the factory punishment enough?
Oh, I don't know. You would have thought she'd stop the privileges or something.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't suggest it if I were you.
All right, you lot, move out. You're going to miss your days out and your little bus trips. I knew one of you would soon do something to ruin it.
You look awful, Vera. Why don't you do something with yourself?
Morning, Vera.
Have you seen this?
What?
The story about that bookkeeper at the Reynolds clothing factory being arrested for embezzlement and larceny. This is the reason for Mrs. Davidson's change of heart about that factory project.
What do you mean?
Well, now she knows there's a police investigation underway, she couldn't cover up the fraud any longer.
Fraud?
Yes, of course. She was prepared to sweep it under the carpet rather than getting her boyfriend Andrew Reynolds into any strife. But now that it's out in the light, she had to act quickly to appear to be doing the right thing.
Look, it really doesn't concern us, Vera. The factory work project has been cancelled, which is what we both wanted. I think we should just forget the whole thing.
You can have that attitude if you want to, but I take my duty a little bit more seriously.
What are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to call the department and make a full report on the matter.
We'd better cut this article out of the papers before the women see it.
Rubbish. They'll find out sooner or later.
No, Vic. I still don't understand why Davo wasn't harder on us. You remember how...
Look, as far as I'm concerned, it's bad enough losing the job. Just think yourself lucky, Doreen.
Well, I know it means a lot more to you than it does to me, because you've got longer to do, but I was just thinking.
Thinking?
You know?
That's one thing you've never been accused of. Why don't you go off and eat a chocolate or something?
Oh, thanks.
Hey, look at this.
What's the matter with you? World War III broken out or something? As if it would make any difference to us. What?
No, it's in the paper about the factory.
Oh, look. A woman's been arrested for theft and embezzlement from the Reynolds clothing factory, Kensington. The woman, Kay White... Bloody Kay.
Yeah, well, that's how Mrs. Davidson would have found out about that extra work with Mr. Reynolds and all that stuff.
Yeah, that bloody Kay must have lagged.
Yeah, and I reckon she set Nolene up. Just like Nolene said, we ought to believe her.
Oh, who'd ever believe anything that bitch said? Mind you, she might be on the level for once.
Well, looks like Kay's mucked up everything.
Well, I promise if anyone was responsible for the work project being cancelled, they'd be sorry.
Well, she might end up in here, you know.
She'll be bloody sorry if she does.
The warrant. Thank you. Stand on that line. Is your name Kay Francis White?
Yes.
Kay Francis White, you are charged with embezzlement and theft and are to be held on remand until your case comes before the court. Now go behind that screen and get undressed. Mrs. Davidson, Kay White is here. Very well. I'll bring her in as soon as she's been processed. Hurry up, White. You've got an appointment with the governor.
Feeling is high amongst the women because their work release has been cancelled. It is possible they may hold you responsible and take reprisals.
But I had nothing to do with that.
I imagine the women may be hard to convince. For that reason, you will be placed in the isolation block for your own protection.
I shouldn't even be in here. I'm sick. I need treatment.
In what way are you ill?
I'm mentally ill. I only took that money because I'm a compulsive gambler.
I don't know the compulsive gambler.
I need psychiatric treatment, not to be locked away. What happened wasn't my fault.
The court will have a fair chance of judging that when your case comes to trial. In the meantime, you will be placed in here in custody.
I shouldn't be. That's not fair.
I see from your file that bail was set, but was not forthcoming.
Oh, how could I pay bail? I'm broke. I gave all the money I had back to Reynolds. Fat lot of good that did me. That bastard wouldn't help me.
Have you no family or friends who could pay the bail? You are entitled to make a phone call or send a telegram, you know.
There isn't anyone. Not with that sort of money.
Well, all I can do, White, is to make sure that the other women do not vent their disappointment on you whilst you are in here. Take White to isolation, please, Miss Bennet.
From what?
Oh, and Miss Bennet, would you return Brian to her usual cell and activities?
Do you think that's wise, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes, Miss Bennet, I do.
Here.
There'll be no talking, Bryant. Just collect your belongings from the cell.
Oh. Well, if I'm getting out, I'm not going to argue, am I?
All right, what?
You know something, Kay? You're going to love it in here. Got lots of exciting things to do all day long, like counting the fly specks on the wall.
I said no talking. I hope you enjoy your own company.
Ladies, da-da-da, the greatest living escape artist.
Well, how are you two?
Hi, Effie.
How are you doing?
Welcome back.
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm fine. Actually, when I was first brought back, I was a bit bitter and twisted, you know. But I thought to myself, what the hell? I'm going to be here for a while. I might as well make the most of it.
That's the way. Don't let them get on top of you.
Oh, it's nice to see you, Jude, though we hope we wouldn't.
Mm. Yeah, well, I guess I probably didn't have much chance of getting away with it, eh?
No, you never do. And that's the voice of experience.
Hey, girls. Guess who I saw being put into the isolation block just now?
Kay White.
I wanted to tell you that. What's she in for?
She'd been fiddling the books at the clothing factory.
That doesn't surprise me.
You say she'd been put into the isolation block?
That's right.
Must be to keep her away from us, which means she is responsible for us losing the work at the factory.
Yeah, they're frightened. We'll get at her.
And so we will.
Well, that's not going to be easy, you know, in isolation.
Yeah, what can we do to her in there?
I'm thinking. There's the meal delivery.
Yeah, and Lizzie's on kitchen duty this week. She's an old hand at slipping things into food.
Yeah, and Margot's there too. And Kay owes Margot money. So Margot's gonna be dead keen to get the bitch.
Yeah, well, that's not gonna get you back to the factory.
No, but it's gonna make me feel much better.
Too much mashed potato, Margot. That's to go round, you know.
G'day, Mrs. O'Regan. Are you ready for me?
Yes, Lizzie. The ones on the end of the bench are for isolation, solitary and maternity. Give her a hand with it, will you, Margot?
Cheer about Kay White.
I read it in the paper. I hope that bitch ends up in here.
She already is. She's in isolation.
Oh, yeah? Well, you'll be delivering her meals, won't you? And give her a message from me. Tell her she's on the inside now and no better than the rest of us, so she'd better pay up the money she owes or else.
Can't do much to her in isolation.
Can't I just? Make sure you give her this one. Mm. Tell her she better pay up the money she owes me, otherwise there'll be worse to come.
All right, Birdsworth, be quick and no talking.
Hello, I'm Lizzie.
Hello.
I got a message for you from Margot. She reckons you better pay her what you owe her or else. And believe me, she means what she says. The other women are crooked on you too.
Why? What have I done to them?
Well, you dobbed them in about the extra work they were doing. And you stopped their work release.
No, I had nothing to do with that.
Well, you laid your hands on quite a bit of dough, or so it says in the papers.
Oh, that wasn't me. The business was going broke and my boss needed someone to blame, so he set me up.
The others are not going to buy that.
Birdsworth, what are you doing?
I said no talking. Now get going.
Oh, I can't eat this muck. This food is dreadful.
The tucker in here always is.
No, something's been done to it. They're trying to poison me.
Will you stop your nonsense, White?
But I can't eat it.
Then you'll go hungry.
I couldn't eat this.
I told you. That's up to you.
They've put something in it. They're trying to poison me. I wish you'd listen.
Why would anyone want to poison you? The food in here is perfectly good. You'll get used to it.
Why won't you listen to me? This food is poisoned. Here, taste it yourself.
I saw this tucker dished up. Same as everybody else got. No one else complained.
Aren't you going to do anything about that?
Will you stop this nonsense? You won't get very far in here carrying on like that.
I want to see the governor.
The governor can't be bothered with complaints about the food.
I want to see the governor. You have to let me.
All right. Come with me. The new prisoner White wants to see you.
Is it important?
I don't think so. It's about the food.
All right, I'll see her.
In here, White.
You have a complaint about the food.
There was something put in it.
What do you mean, something?
I don't know. The women are out to get me. They've put something in my food.
I know I warned you the women may be against you, but don't you think you may be jumping to conclusions now?
No, I am not. They're trying to poison me. Why won't anyone listen to me?
Did you taste the food, Miss Bennet?
No. I'm used to the prisoners complaining.
Where is the meal now?
I had it sent back to the kitchen.
I see. All right, White, I'll look into the matter.
I should be getting better treatment than this. I'm not even guilty. I should be out on bail by rights if I had the money.
Do you have legal representation?
No, I haven't. I can't afford it.
Well, legal aid will look after that. Take White to see Miss Forster and ask her to arrange a visit from a legal aid solicitor.
Very well. Come on.
Oh, and Miss Bennet, I shall be out for a short while.
Make a good case for me. I'll be out of here before you know it. I should never have been put in here anyway.
You'd be surprised how often I've heard that, White.
Oh, no, no. This time it's true. You'll see. Mr. Spencer is very optimistic about my chances. You will thank the social worker for getting me a solicitor, won't you?
Yes, of course.
I'll be glad to get out of here. I don't mind telling you.
All right, Gaffney.
Did Miss Forster get White a solicitor?
Yes, she did. But I'm surprised he came. You should have heard the way she spoke to him on the phone.
Like your meals, do you? Enjoy what you got yesterday.
It's not fair my being victimized because the work release was cancelled. That wasn't my fault.
I don't give a damn about that. All I want is the money you owe me. And if I don't get it, you're going to be sorry. Real sorry.
Well, then, I'd better give you what I owe you, hadn't I?
She as good as condoned the fact that the inmates were using the work release program for their own means, all because she was personally involved with Reynolds. Now, I could...
Swallow it!
How
White! How disgusting! On your feet! Well, it didn't take you long to show your true colors, did it?
I wanted her to taste it first, just in case she tried to poison me again.
I should have poisoned you when I had the chance.
On your way, Gaffney.
Welcher.
And I want that cleaned up by the time I get back.
That was pretty stupid, White.
What was I supposed to do? I reported her once and nothing was done about it. I didn't want her to poison me again.
Well, what's wrong with her this time?
Nothing. Except I wouldn't feed it to a dog.
You're in enough trouble as it is, White. I wouldn't make it any worse for yourself. Especially not with the other women.
I just didn't feel like eating that slop, that's all. But you didn't even have any breakfast, Dor. And that mince was the best we had for ages. There wasn't even any gristle.
Well, the smell was enough to turn anyone off.
Listen, honey, if you're not feeling okay, you should report to the sick bay.
Look, I put on some of that weight I took off, okay?
Grant, report to me in an hour. I've got a job for you.
How nice to be needed.
Don't push me, Bryant, or you could find yourself back in isolation. And why aren't you on kitchen duty?
Oh, it's just on my way, Miss Bennet.
Well, you've got a strange sense of direction.
How'd you get on with you know who doing you know what?
The next time I get a minute alone with her, she's going to cop it, so help me.
You should be grateful there won't be a next time, Gaffney. You didn't do too well this time.
She owes me.
Owes you what?
She owes all of us for snitching and getting us taken off the factory scheme. How else had the government found out about it?
Come on, Dor. It was all I could lay me hands on, and I did make it myself.
I don't want it, Lizzie.
But you got to get something into you. And Kev loves you the way you are.
Will you leave me alone?
Seems a pity to waste it.
Oh, who's gonna waste it? Oh. So you decided to start a one-man band, did you, Margot?
She owed me dough. I just wanted to collect, that's all.
Well, I warned you right from the start about starting up a book. Now what you've done is gone and botched it up for the rest of us. The screws gonna be watching her like hawks.
Don't you ever forget about getting even for once. Look, you're the ones that made the deal with Reynolds, right? And you're the ones who knew that the work release would get stopped if you got caught, so why blame Kay?
Because she lagged to draw attention away from the fact that she was ripping Reynolds off.
You don't know that for sure.
What's your stake in this?
Well, when I was going to make a run for it, she got me a dress. She tried to help me, that's all.
Well, you can bet there was a reason for that too, don't you worry. But if you feel you owe her, well, that is your problem. Just stay out of our way. Now, we're not going to be able to get her while she's in isolation, which leaves us with the problem of getting her out of there.
Oh, sure. Break her out, I suppose.
We've done harder things.
I told you to clean that up.
With what?
You're very good at thinking for yourself on the outside. Surely 24 hours in here can't have changed that. You've missed some. Ever since you arrived, you've been in isolation. Yet Gaffney seems to think you owe her money. Perhaps there was more going on at the factory than the governor was aware of. Get a move on, Brandt. Well?
Well, what? I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, let go of me! Don't you ever lay a hand on an officer again.
I want to see the social worker, please.
You saw her this morning.
I need to see her again.
What for?
She got a solicitor for me. He suggested I see a psychiatrist. I want her to arrange it.
At least you admit you need help.
I don't admit anything, but it's not helping being in here.
It's for your own protection.
You stay in here, you hear? You stay
Bryant.
In isolation. You stay here no matter what.
Get
understand?
Moving, Bryant.
You have been warned on several occasions that any abuse of this work release would end in its cancellation. Now some of you seem to think that Kay White is largely responsible. In case I didn't make myself clear before, I acted on a report given to me by one of the officers. Any further persecution of this woman will stop as of now. She has already been placed under unnecessary pressure by some of you, and I assure you it will achieve nothing. I know how important this program was to you. It meant a great deal to all of us. However, any further rehabilitation programs will be kept within the prison.
What rehabilitation program?
Mrs. Davidson's been more than fair, Smith. As far as she's concerned, the matter is forgotten. And from now on, there'll be more variation in routine.
Oh, I suppose we get up at 5 o'clock now instead of 6, do we?
It may interest you to know that H Block is having a barbecue this evening.
Oh, we'll be.
Now, if it's a success, it could become a once-a-week event, and the rest of the prison will be included. But it's entirely up to you.
Mrs. Jackson, can I lie down for a bit? I'm feeling a bit crook.
Have you been to dispensary?
I'm just tired, you know, run down.
Come along with me.
You see, old Davo's okay. She's gonna give us a barbecue.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Keep us happy little Vegemites and we'll be all love and forgiveness.
Oh, for crying out loud, don't you ever let up?
I am just stopped buying what Davo has to sell, that's all.
Now, look, what she said about pressuring Kay, she's right. You push that girl too far and she's going to go right over the edge.
Yeah. Oh, you're probably right, Drew. We should forget what happened.
You don't mean that.
No, I mean really. Why don't we just extend the hand of friendship? And I reckon you should make the offer.
Well, all right. But only if you promise me that you'll give her a good chance at clearing her name. Otherwise, no deal.
Yeah, sure.
You'll have to wait until the morning.
Oh, isn't there someone else I
can... one more day is not going to make any difference. Mrs. Davidson, wait here. Miss Forster's gone home for the day.
Oh, is it anything important?
White says she wants to see a psychiatrist. Although it could be just a trick to help her at her trial.
Well, as a matter of fact, Dr. Wiseman will be here this afternoon anyway.
What about Miss Forster? Surely you can't ignore all this. Ever since she's come here, she's done nothing but sip cups of tea. She's inefficient, and she hasn't locked the door to her office.
Well, I'll speak to her tomorrow. Oh, by the way, I've arranged for some of the women to have a barbecue this evening, weather permitting. I don't think a little relaxation will do them any harm at this stage.
But they've broken every rule in the book.
Miss Bennet, in case you haven't noticed, there's a lot of ill feeling at the moment. I'm trying to avoid a situation getting completely out of hand.
Yes. I suppose you can't really afford any more trouble with the department.
Thank you for your support, Miss Bennet.
Sergeant, showing the screws, they can never take our word for anything again.
Listen, all's going to happen at the barbecue is that she's going to be greeted like a long-lost sister. Anyone would think we was getting a visit from the Queen. We even had to make out we were putting down the red carpet.
Yeah, well, let's not go overboard. Just nice and friendly will do.
You all right, Dor?
I'm trying to sleep.
Oh, come on, love. You better put on something warm in case it turns cold.
I'm not going.
All right, Doreen, enough's enough. You are going to eat if I have to force it down your throat.
I feel sick.
Listen, you stupid little idiot. I'm not having you starving and winding up with a tube in your arm.
Yeah, Bea's right, you know. Anyway, what's wrong with a few pounds, eh?
You don't want to end up looking like a scarecrow like me, do?
Look, it's not putting on a few pounds that's worrying me. I'm bloody scared to death because I'm pregnant.
Then why are you looking as if your throat's been cut?
Oh, that's fantastic, honey.
Oh, you're gonna be a mother.
Oh, why don't you tell us, for God's sake? Everyone gets morning sickness.
Yeah, and that doesn't last long. One more reason why you have to keep up your strength.
Hey, that day out with Kev sure did the trick.
No, it's not Kevin's. Can't be. It isn't his.
Of course I'm sure. I've been pregnant before. I know what it's like. I've checked the dates. And it can't be Kevin's. It's got to be that Vince Talbot creeps.
Bastard. Wish I'd kill him when I had the chance.
Yeah. What am I going to do? Kevin and me want to have our own kids. How can I tell him I've got someone else's inside of me?
The rotten mongrel. It's not your fault, love. He forced you into it. Nobody's gonna blame you.
Funny, he'd said something the first time he tried it.
How could I? He would have stopped the work release and none of you were around to help me.
Judy was there.
Not in the storeroom, she wasn't. Not when he... Oh, I was too scared.
Okay, there's no point going over all that. It's too late now.
Yeah, well, I know what I'd like to do to him. Just 1 minute alone with that guy, that's all I'd need.
Yeah, we're not going to get that chance now, though, are we? Thanks to your friend, Kay White.
Now, why blame Kay? It's Vince Talbot we should be tearing to pieces.
We could report him. We could get him stuck into jail.
Oh, sure. They're going to listen to a pack of criminals, aren't they? The same way that they listened to us telling them who killed Sharon.
I don't want anyone else to know. Please, Bea.
I promise you this much, Doreen. No man is going to get away with what he did to you. I don't know how, or when, or where. But he is going to pay.
What good does it do to go into my background? I've already told you, I come from a boring middle-class family with not so much as a parking ticket between the lot of them. It's now we ought to be talking about. Look, do you think I would have taken that money back if I was a criminal?
I take it you saw it as a loan.
I had a winner. I knew it. I could feel it. You don't turn your back on that sort of feeling.
What would have happened if it hadn't won?
I just told you. I knew it was a winner.
Yes, but you were juggling the books at the factory for some time prior to that. Didn't you see that as a crime?
No, I never intended keeping the money. Look, all I needed was one good win. I was close. I could feel it. Just one to come home at, say, 20-1 with 5,000 riding on it, I'd have had it made.
In what way? Wealth or pay back your gambling debts?
I'd have won.
Is there a history of gambling in your family?
No. My father was a bank manager. You know how tight they are with money. The biggest bet he ever had was 50 cents each way on the Melbourne Cup.
Do you think he was overly careful with his money?
No. They were always giving me presents, especially if I did well at school. And I did. The more successful I was, the more they boasted.
Well, wasn't that a worry to you? You know, trying to live up to a certain standard?
Of course not. I loved it. The best at everything. There's no feeling quite like it.
You must have had a lot of friends.
People looked up to me. Ever played the poker machines?
Oh, once or twice.
You put a little money in, and it pays out. Or just a little at first, but you're hooked. Then you put some more money in, and it doesn't pay out. And then it's between you and that machine. You've got to beat it, get that jackpot. Then you're a winner.
What happens if you do win the jackpot, Kay, or your horse comes in? Do you think you could stop?
Once you win, there's nowhere else to go.
Well, you could always go on trying to win. You know, break the bank.
I could stop. I could do anything if I wanted to. But that's what you're here for, isn't it? To help me.
Well, I've got as many doubts about this barbecue as you do, Vera. But at least we should see if the idea works before we knock it on the head.
You know why she's doing this? She's panicking because she knows if there's one more incident, they'll see how incompetent she really is. So what is she doing? She's pandering to the prisoners to keep them quiet. And they'll use her, don't you worry about that, which will make our job that much harder.
Vera, if I hear one more word against Mrs. Davidson, so help me, I might just put in a report of my own.
You must see what's happening. Wentworth is getting slacker by the minute.
All I see is a woman under a lot of strain, trying to do a good job and getting absolutely no support from some of the senior members of her staff.
She is under no more strain than we are. Unless, of course, you're talking about personal pressures.
Well, you two knock it off. I'm getting sick and tired of the infighting that's going on around this place. As senior members of staff, we have a right to express doubts about certain decisions that are made. But I agree with you, it should be done out in the open and not behind anybody's back. Why women can't discuss things calmly is beyond me. Now, if you two ladies will excuse me, I've got work to do.
He should be working in a men's prison. He's got the first idea about women.
Dr. Wiseman should be finished with White by now. I better go and get her.
Come and get it!
Oh, yeah. Bloody rain!
Nearly starved to death here, I bet.
Just don't want to treat like any other newcomer. Mind you, an apology or two wouldn't go astray, seeing as how we done her wrong. But no grudges, no nothing. I want her out of isolation. Feeling better?
Mmm. Tastes real good.
Good on you, love. You've got to eat.
Shame it was raining. It would have been good to have the barbie outside.
Pick yourself lucky old Dave, let us have it at all.
You know, Lizzie, Margot.
Good day, love. I'm glad they let you out, even if it's only for tea. I reckon we got you to thank for all this.
Reckon we got off on the wrong foot. No hard feelings, huh?
All right. Hi. Welcome to the indoor Barbie, doll.
I read in the papers about how you got caught.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't if I hadn't tried to give the money back.
Some people got no gratitude.
So far, so good.
A little bit too friendly, if you ask me. But you feel right at home here. Just move from one factory to the next.
Hamburger.
Pick it up, Birdsworth.
Miss Bennett has taken her to dispensary. I don't think it's too bad.
It seems I misjudged you, Bryant. I shall certainly think twice before taking your word for anything again.
I swear to you that none of us knew there was anything in that, Mrs. Davidson.
You two were responsible for preparing the meal.
The last time I was accused of putting something in me cooking, I got 20 years. I was innocent then, too.
Gaffney broke a glass when I was in the kitchen, Mrs. Davidson.
Must have fallen in accidentally.
You will be confined to your cell for 24 hours.
But I...
Be quiet. As you were all obviously responsible, you can tell the others there will be no more barbecues. And that is final. You may go.
Wait in the corridor. I take it White will have to stay in isolation.
No matter what I decide, it always seems to be the wrong decision.
Look, why don't you go home early? You look very tired.
I have too much work to do.
I can wait.
I'm not seeing Andrew again. I had to make a decision. Another decision.
This must be quite a blow to your pride. One minute they think you're so important, the next minute they turn on you. But then you're not much use to them anymore, are you?
It was fun while it lasted.
You think you're so smart, White. But what's so clever about joining forces with a bunch of criminals? Or was it just a game to you?
Actually, you're right. It wasn't that much fun. You see, it was so easy to con you. There's no sport involved when you're dealing with officers with an average IQ of below zero.
This letter arrived for White at the front gate. She may as well have it now. I've already censored it.
Thank you. You got a letter? Regulations state that all mail must be censored by an officer. It's from the foreman at the factory, Talbot. Very interesting. He says you owe him $250. You must have made quite a group. You embezzling the company, Reynolds' fraudulent behavior, and Talbot. This letter speaks for itself.
He's a pig.
Mrs. Davidson's usually very good at assessing people. I'm amazed she wasn't onto the type she was dealing with sooner. You were Reynolds' assistant. Was he just out to use Mrs. Davidson's position? Or didn't she care?
I'll tell you something that'll really interest you, Miss Bennett. I wouldn't give you the time of day if you begged for it.
You owe that man nothing. He was the one that got you arrested.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I can't stand him. But you, you're the vilest thing I've ever met.
Knowing that what's inside of me is that man's.
It's half yours too, love.
Yeah. I keep trying to pretend that it's all mine. But I keep seeing Talbot. And it should be Kevin's.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing, Lizzie. Get back to sleep.
I keep going over it and over it, you know. And I reckon that I could probably tell Kevin that it's his, and well, after it's
what
born.
What good would that do if you're going to hate it so much? Look, there's nothing worse than having a kid you don't want, Doreen. If you decide to go through with this, you've got to love it while it's in you and when it's born. You're not going to fool Kevin. And you're just going to make a little kid's life a misery.
Are you telling her to get rid of it?
I'm trying to help her face facts, Lizzie, and lying's not going to help anyone.
Oh, you've always loved kids, Dor. They took away your first one. You're not going to lose your second one. You'll learn to love her, you see. And it doesn't matter whose it is.
It does if she can't cope with it. Look, Dor's young. Got a whole tribe of kids ahead of you. Ones you and Kevin want.
Well, what would you do if you was me, Bea?
I'm not you, love. I'm never going to be able to have any more kids. So if I could, wouldn't matter who the father was.
I keep trying to forget what he did to me, you know. I was doing real good, too. But this is going to keep reminding me of him.
Can I see Dr. Weissman again today, please?
He's not due back for a couple of days, but if you wish to see him sooner...
You ask me, they should all see him. They're all killers and you're not doing a thing to stop them.
Gaffney's been punished for what she did. And as far as we can tell, no one else had anything to do with what happened yesterday.
Oh, I had nothing to do with their stupid work release being cancelled. I'm going mad in here.
It's only a temporary precaution.
Look, we're allowed a phone call a week, aren't we?
Yes. Who do you want to call?
Vince Talbot. He's the foreman at the...
I know him. You can call him after breakfast. Hurry up, Brian.
You listen, while you're talking to that son of a bitch, you can give him a message from me. We're going to get him, no matter how long it takes.
Bryant!
Come in.
Kay White wants to see you. She says it's important.
All right, bring her in.
What?
If I don't get out of isolation today, I'm going to tell my solicitor you're treating me unfairly.
Don't you ever come into my office making demands like that again. Do you hear me? You are in there, White, for your own protection, and you will stay there until I think it's safe for you to mix with the others.
Oh, they're not going to hurt me anymore.
You've certainly changed your tune since this morning.
It was something Judy mentioned. Look, I know they've forgotten all about me. Give me 5 minutes alone with them and I'll prove it to you. Well, if I believe them, why don't you?
Because whilst you are in here, you are our responsibility.
Then you are responsible for driving me insane by keeping me locked up in isolation.
Wait outside.
Oh, hello, dear. I believe you wanted to see me.
Yes, a little bit later on, if that's all right.
Of course, any time. My door is always open.
Thanks, Mrs. Jackson. I'll be all right.
A word of advice. If there are any more incidents involving injury to White, no matter how accidental, you will all be held responsible.
Oh, you got us all wrong, Mrs. J. That was Margot's fight. Had nothing to do with us. We'll take care of her.
She'll be moving in with you, Judy. I'll leave it to you to see she stays out of trouble.
Either you are very stupid or you like to live dangerously.
Look, I helped you all at the factory, didn't I? And now I think I can help you again.
I wouldn't trust you if you're on your deathbed.
You've taken a sudden dislike to Vince Talbot. Why, what's he done?
It's none of your business.
Yeah. We hear you and him are good friends.
No, you got it all wrong. I can't stand him any more than you can, which is where I think I can help. I'll make a deal with you. You let me go my own way, and I'll hand you Talbot on a silver platter.
Thank you.
ladies, we're going to get ourselves a bastard.
Then there. Oh, no. I mean, when we're let out, we're persecuted, we're terrorised. Look what happened to Doreen. She's let out in a work release programme. Big deal. They're doing us a favour. And what happens? She gets raped. And you know why she gets raped?
Yeah. Because if she didn't go along with what Talbert said, he would have stopped the work release. Oh, it was all good, clean fun, wasn't it? After all she was a woman prisoner.
Yeah, exactly.
But you tried getting back him at the factory, Bea.
There wasn't enough time to teach him a real lesson.
Yeah, well, by the time we finished with him, he won't be able to look at another woman. No point.
Bad news?
Yeah, little Josie's going to have her operation soon, probably at the end of this week. Ellen's been too flat out organising doctors and stuff to come over here and tell me.
Don't worry, love. They'll be all right.
Yeah.
Well?
3:30, like you wanted.
It's going to be the first exercise period I've enjoyed for some time. Ah, oh, come on, Phil, put some life in it. You're as slow as a wet week.
I'm saving me strength for the game.
I've got to see her before the operation door, just for a couple of hours, that's all.
Well, why don't you ask that new social worker to arrange it? Because Mr. Reed used to do that for us.
And what Kay reckons, I might as well wrangle a holiday on Surfers Paradise.
Don't give the game away. Make you feel welcome, for God's sake.
Hiya, handsome. How you going?
Baba! You'll be sorry you set foot in here, Talbert.
See you later, love.
Well, if it wasn't for Miss Forster's help here, I wouldn't even have a solicitor.
You told me you were going to pay me now.
Oh, I know. I had to tell you that so you'd come. You wouldn't let me explain over the phone. But look, after my trial, I'll get a job and I'll have the money to you within a couple of weeks.
You're a liar.
Will you keep a civil tongue in your head, Mr. Talbert?
Vince, please. I am sick, but I'm getting treatment. And when I'm better...
Sick be damned. You're a thief. That's what you are.
I won't tell you again, Mr. Talbert.
You're not getting away with this. I'm warning you. If I don't clap eyes on that $250 before your trial, I'll see to it that your name is mud.
I'm glad you said that in front of me, Mr. Talbert. I'm sure the police would be more than interested to learn that you threatened to slant your testimony for money. Now, they mightn't take Kay's word for it, but they'll certainly take mine.
Say you just fell over. Otherwise, you're gonna find yourself inside for rape.
Smithers. Could you get this lot inside?
What good's it doing asking me? Bloke's walking along, minding his own business, and all of a sudden he gets flattened by a pack of women. What are you running here, a madhouse?
Prior to your attack, I was informed by Miss Forster that you threatened one of the inmates, Kay White.
What's that got to do with me? Almost getting murdered.
I am trying to establish a reason for the assault. The women claim you were accidentally knocked over during a game of volleyball.
Oh, come on. Look, you were there. She didn't believe me. You tell her what happened.
Officer Meadows and I were trying to break up a fight amongst some of the women. I did see Mr. Talbot on the ground, but I didn't see anyone hit him.
Oh, bloody hell.
Mr. Talbot, if what you say is true, I will punish the women involved. For instance, can you think of any reason why this should happen? Was there anything you said or did whilst they were working at the factory?
Isn't my word good enough for you?
When an accusation like this is made, I have to have proof, or at least a motive.
All right, look, forget it. It was just an accident. I tripped and fell over. Is that okay? Does that keep your precious record straight?
I am just trying to find out.
Look, forget it.
Then I suggest you don't visit Wentworth again.
Oh, lady, it'll be a pleasure.
For some reason, Mr. Talbot decided not to press charges. However, I am not at all convinced that it was an accident. Should I ever discover that the incident was deliberate and premeditated, suitable punishment will be arranged. One day, you might not be quite so lucky.
Excuse me, Mrs. Jackson. Can I go and see Miss Forster for a minute? It's very urgent.
All right, Lizzie, but it's Miss Forster.
Oh, I'm always getting me peas and brews mixed up.
I'm surprised you're in such good humour. Or maybe you find something else amusing?
Did it, we did it!
Yeah, here's a good old justice.
So long as the governor doesn't find out.
And who's gonna lag,
No one. But as I see it, I did the groundwork. I thought up the idea. Therefore, I should be paid for services rendered.
You were paid, and we said we'd lay off you.
No. That's not good enough.
Oh, yes, it is, sweetie. So just shut up before I change my mind.
I reckon anyone who loves animals must be a real decent sort.
I couldn't agree with you more, Elizabeth.
I had a cat once and a dog, but one dropped dead on me and the other one got taken away.
Oh, how dreadful for you.
Yeah, everything that I've ever loved has always something happened to it.
Oh, it's tragic when one loses an animal. They're like one of the family.
True. You never know what's just around the corner. Take my little granddaughter, for instance. One minute, right as rain, and the next, just when she needed me most, I'm not there.
Elizabeth, you leave everything to me. I'll make sure you see Josie before her operation. And I'll just take this letter here to get the details.
Oh, I knew you'd sort it out. You got real heart, Miss Forster.
Forster.
Oh, yeah. And thanks for the cuppa. That's what I really miss in this place, a cup of afternoon tea and a real natter.
Well, Butchie, another job well done. Now, just one little drink before we go home. Come on, Butchie. Butchie, Butchie, Butchie. Butchie, Butchie. Oh.
She's real understanding, Dor. I reckon if you was to talk to her, she'd tell you what to do. Them social workers know it all.
The only ones who can decide anything are Doreen and Kevin.
Well, I'm going to tell him the truth, Lizzie.
Oh, it'll be all right. He's always stuck by you before.
Yeah, Judy doesn't reckon I should, though.
Listen, all I said is that some men are funny about rape.
No, he's a good kid.
Yeah, well, you probably know him better than me.
Look, he'll understand. All I have to say is that I got pregnant because I was raped. I don't have to go into the details.
Oh, brother.
You've got to expect a few questions, love.
Well, what if he doesn't understand? What if he leaves me?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson, but I thought you'd want to hear this immediately.
It's about the attack on Vince Talbot. It wasn't an accident. It was deliberate.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Right.